Introduction to VividData. This introductory guide is focused on creating and interpreting simple tables. VividData is an industry organization created through a partnership between Canadian media organizations and Canadian advertisers. They pull Canadians to gather the data needed to answer the perennial questions of advertisers and publishers. Questions about what products and services Canadians are buying. What are their ages, incomes, and other demographic characteristics? What are their opinions about such topics as recycling, shopping, traveling, and dieting? VividData's survey of the Canadian consumer reaches over 30,000 Canadians each year and produces detailed data on Canadian opinions, demographics, and activities, as well as their product, service, and media purchases. The VividData database, available through the Conestoga Library, allows you to connect those puzzle pieces in many ways to answer different questions. For instance, what energy drinks do female millennials drink most often? Which province has the most people who attend pro hockey games? Are frequent gardeners likely to be open to trying new food products? And are hybrid car owners likely to pay more for products that elevate their status? Creating a table. We can create a VividData table in four main parts. A. Identifying splits and questions. B. Select the split. C. Select the question. And D. Final steps. We can demonstrate how to search VividData by using a sample question. Are Canadian Red Bull drinkers more likely to be pre-boomers, baby boomers, Generation X, Generation Y, or Generation Z? A. Identify splits and questions. We will construct our table by placing variables in one of the two categories, splits and questions. Splits represent our target portion of the population. Think of this as the group about whom we want to know something. In this case, it's Canadian Red Bull drinkers. More specifically, we're interested in learning about the Canadians who are 14 years or older, since that's the youngest age surveyed, who claim that Red Bull is the energy drink brand that they purchase most often. Question. The information we would like to have about our target group or split. In this case, we want to know how many people in our split are in each of these major generational cohorts. Pre-boomers, baby boomers, Gen X, Gen Y, and Gen Z. B. Select the split. Step 1. Search for energy or browse the beverages category to find the variable called beverages, energy sport drinks, energy drinks, brands personally drink most often. This refers to a question from the survey relating to energy sport drinks that may ask something like, what energy sport drink brands do you drink most often? In most cases, you will need to first search for product types, not brand name. Specific brands like Red Bull can be selected in a later step that I'll soon demonstrate. Step 2. Cursor over your chosen topic and select Add as Split from the options that appear. Step 3. In the text box that is now under the column area, click the details that show which of the variables are currently selected. In this case, it says 9 of 9 selected in blue highlighting. Clicking opens a list of brands available for this topic. Then select Red Bull from that list. You'll note it now says 1 of 9 selected. You could also hold down the Control key and select multiple brands. But we're keeping this sample table simple by focusing on just the single brand. C. Select the question. Step 5. search, or browse. To find the generation demographic, found under demographics/age/generation, generation, then cursor over it and add it as a question to your table. As a side note, besides demographics, you will find VividData to be rich with psychographics, which are found within the category called personal characteristics. It is worth your time to browse through the categories to see the many areas available, but for this demonstration, I'll keep it simple. Step 6. Delete the default question 14+, as it isn't needed for the topic we are researching, but leave the default 14+ split. This means we'll see information on all respondents, who again are 14 and up. No one younger was surveyed. Again, we are aiming for simplicity for this sample table. It's fine to include multiple questions in a more complex table. D. Final steps. Step 7. Click on the Calculations tab. Step 8. Then select the option to enable benchmark calculation and adjust the calculation option to index conversion rate. These benchmark settings will make it easier to interpret the table in our next step. If you haven't done so already, click on the Generate tab to display the table we designed in the last section. You should now see the table. This simple table, with just 32 cells and 42 numbers, is packed with information about the ages of Red Bull drinkers, the drink choices of different generations, and the survey response counts of those in 5 major generational cohorts. Remember, when we created our search, we enabled the benchmark calculation. In our view, benchmarking is one of the most powerful and useful features of VividData. Enabling benchmarking will let you see whether one group is more or less likely than another group for a particular variable to apply to them. When you turn on benchmarking, by default, all columns will be compared against the first column. Let's break down the first column of this table because that's the column we will compare Red Bull drinkers against. The count is the number of people in the population projected to have positively responded to the question. All counts in a table are weighted. Because of this, all counts, with the exception of the unweighted base, in other words, the sample size, should be multiplied by 1,000 to get the actual number. The unweighted base can be read as a straight number. From the first column, we learn that the survey sample size consisted of 31,233 respondents who fit within the 5 generational groups. Each person in the sample is projected to represent a certain number of people in the population. When projected onto the Canadian population, the 31,233 respondents represent 32,349,000 Canadians in the 5 major generational cohorts. Next, we read that of the 32 million, 25.1%, or 8,107,000, are in the Gen Y generation. Having enabled benchmarking, we can compare whether one generation is more or less likely than another to drink Red Bull. Let's look at the right column to continue with comparative interpretations. Of the 31,223 survey respondents, 956 of them said that Red Bull is the brand of energy drink that they drink most often. This represents approximately 1,107,000 people in the 5 major generational cohorts who most often drank Red Bull when choosing an energy drink. Of all the people who reported that Red Bull is the energy drink brand that they consume most often, 48.9% are Gen Y. However, only 25.1% of those in the 5 major age generational cohorts are Gen Y. So major Red Bull drinkers are more likely to be Gen Y than you might expect, given the generation's share of the population. Next, we'll look at numbers relating to the likelihood index. This number tells us if a group is more or less likely for a particular variable to apply to them. It is measured relative to average Canadians, which is always 100, with more than 100 read as more likely and less than 100 read as less likely. And so if we continue in the right column with our interpretation, we learn from the 194.6 index value that our Red Bull group is 94.6% more likely to be of the Gen Y age group than is the average population to be Gen Y. Conversely, of all the Canadians in the Gen Y age group, 8,107,000, 7% state that they consume Red Bull most often. As we've seen through examples from this one table, VividData allows us to connect the puzzle pieces in many ways to answer different questions about Red Bull consumers. This concludes our introduction to creating and interpreting simple tables from VividData. For further help, please contact the library.